So the next component that we are going to be looking at is a capacitor. Capacitors have different types. If you look here on a motherboard, there are many. This one is called electrolytic capacitors. These are called ceramic capacitors. These are also called ceramic capacitors, but they use a lot of current, and they are usually around the processors and the RAM power supplies. These ceramic capacitors are the more that are used on the motherboard. You can see them everywhere. The function of these ceramic capacitors, they are used for filtering out noise. They are used for storing charge. They can be used as protection devices, like protection against short circuit, protection against reverse voltages. And these capacitors are non-polarized. They don't have positive or negative. They can work either direction. But these ones have positive and negative. That's why you see they have a label on this side. These ones are non-polarized, but these ones are polarized the same as this one. That's why you see these ones have got plus signs at the extreme end. So let's check for this capacitor. It's called C27-2. So this is it here. And this capacitor, the schematic shows it is under CPU core. And you can still see the sign of the plus sign on it, on the other side, and the negative on the ground side. Okay? The best way you can check if a capacitor is faulty, you can use a multimeter to check in continuity mode. So one of these side is ground, and another one is not ground. So some of these capacitors look like they are short when the processor is inside. But you can see that this side, which has got a positive line, has got more resistance. That's why you see it has 22 ohms, and this ground side has got almost 2.4 ohms. So this is the negative, this is the positive. If this capacitor was faulty, it should be measured in 1.8 ohms, and that should be the same this way if it was faulty. But if it is measuring 21 ohms, it is fine. I'll show you if we take out this processor, the capacitor will be beeping only on one side. So after getting out the processor, if we measure the resistance of this capacitor, here it is still 2.3. Here, it's no longer beeping. That's another way you can check if a capacitor is faulty. If this capacitor was beeping on both sides, when the processor is out, it would be short. Then the second way you can check for capacitors, if you have a meter, you can go under capacitance. You see this sign here. This is the capacitance sign. You go. This is the capacitor. You see that it has NF, which is nanofarads. You come and put your negative on ground and put your positive here. So it will be able to calculate the capacitance of this capacitor. So here you see it is showing 3.355 megafarads. These numbers are always, most times are written here, even in the schematics, okay? So if you look in the schematics here, you see that it is labeled 330 microfarads. This U means microfarads, okay? And here they will show you that these capacitors are 4, and all of them total up to 470 microfarads. So if you look on this capacitor here, can you see that number, which is a 330? You see this one? This number shows how much farads this capacitor is rated. That's why when we measured under capacitance, the meter was able to show us 33. You see? So this capacitor is fine. Now the next part we are going to look at is MOSFET. MOSFETs look like this. This one is, these are the protection MOSFETs from this battery connector to this charging section. MOSFETs have got different functions on a motherboard. One, they are used as switches. Two, they are used as protection. Then three, they are used in creating different voltages on the motherboard. MOSFETs are very, very crucial on a motherboard, and it's very hard to find a motherboard that doesn't have a MOSFET. The symbol of a MOSFET in the schematics, let's check like this one. This one is called P252. Another thing I want to point out is any label that any company that has got P2 is MOSFET or a transistor. Q is used for transistors and MOSFETs. C is used for capacitors. D is used for diodes. And L is used for inductors. So let's check for this MOSFET to see the symbol it uses. This one is P252. P252. So you see it is here. It is actually called AO4407A. Now this number that the schematic is showing us is always written on these MOSFETs. So this MOSFET, you see it has got three lines this way and four lines this way. These four lines and another one here. This is what they call the gate, the one line that is separate. These four lines are always connected on the motherboard. I don't know if you can see them here, but these four pins this side are all connected on the same rail. Can you see it? Then these three are also connected. So this one is separate. Let me show you when to use a continuity mode. This pin here is connected with this one. It's connected with this one also. And with this one. Those are the four pins that you see here on this side. Then here these three pins are also connected together. This one and this one. Except this one. This one is not connected to them. So this last one is what we call the gate. So in the schematics here, you can see that this MOSFET has got what we call pin number 1, 2, 3, 4, which is the gate, 5, 6, 7, 8. Here on the MOSFET, can you see this small black dot? This black dot you see at the end here, it also symbolizes pin number 1. Then when you look here, can you see this white line with this kind of curve? It also symbolizes where pin number 1 is connected. Okay, so here it shows that pin number 1, pin number 2 and pin number 3 are connected. That's why you see in the schematics pin number 1, pin number 2, pin number 3 are all connected. Pin number 4 is the gate, which is separated here. Then another thing that you have to know, that if pin number 1 is here, we calculate these pins going in this direction. I think that's what we call the, is it the anti-clockwise? I think you always do this arrow when you are calculating those pins. Even on these big chips, you can see here we have this small arrow which shows the pin number 1. We also have this pin here, and these ones are calculated like this. That's why you see here is pin number 1, here it is pin 32, 33, then we come as pin 34, 35, 96, then 97 up to 128. So they are calculated in this direction. Pin 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So the way you can check whether this MOSFET is shorted or faulty, there are two methods. You can check by continuity. If you find that these four pins that are connected and these three pins are connected are beeping, if one of this side is beeping to the gate, it shows a shorted MOSFET. Then another thing you can do, another method you can check MOSFET, is by diode. As you see from the schematics here, this MOSFET has got what we call a diode in the middle. Okay, so this diode connects from these four pins into these three pins. So you use the diode mode and you put the black probe on this black arrow here. So it means black probe goes to the three connected pins, and then the red probe comes on these four connected pins. So the four connected pins are this way, then the three are here. So this diode will show you the voltage forward drop. That's why you see it as 0.5. Then if you interchange these pins and you connect them opposite, it shows that it's infinity, where which means that the volts cannot pass from this side to this side. It only allows volts to flow in one direction. This is what we call data sheet of these MOSFETs. And these MOSFETs are all labeled. You see these numbers, like this one is called 6718. So if you want to get the data sheet of this MOSFET, you can use this number. You Google it on Google, and they will give you its data sheet when you want to read more about this MOSFET.